Hi, I'm Lindsay Baumgren of Nourish, Move, Love, and today I'm sharing six of my favorite exercises for the abs, butt, and thighs. We're gonna hit all three muscle groups, abs, butt, and thighs from all angles with six bodyweight exercises. So no equipment needed, but if you have a chair, a couch, a bench, grab something like that that you can use to support yourself, and we'll use it for some single leg sit back chair squats. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Your workout looks like this. We're gonna do a quick warm up to get ourselves started, and then we're gonna jump into six bodyweight exercises. You're gonna do each exercise for 40 seconds of work followed by 20 seconds of rest, and we're gonna do two sets. It's gonna round out around 15 minutes. Quick and effective bodyweight abs, butt, and thigh workout. You can do it on your own or add it on to another workout. So let's go ahead and get ourselves started with a nice little warm up. We're gonna take a nice wide stance, toes slightly out but facing me. You're just gonna sit those hips back side to side. Push those hips right back towards the wall behind you. Nice, hitting the inner thighs, pushing through the heel of the bent leg, getting the glutes involved. Nice, just push back side to side. There you go, give me 8, 7, 6, you got it. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. From here, take a nice wide leg forward fold because it feels good. It opens up that posterior chain. Nice. From here, go ahead, drop that seat down. Go ahead, take a couple wide squat rocks. Just open up those hips. Nice work. Take another wide forward fold. Roll all the way up to the top. When you get to the top, give me two big shoulder rolls, up, back, and down, up, back, and down. Now we're gonna go side to side. So give me a narrow squat, a wide squat, a narrow squat, a wide squat. Nice. Going through a narrow and wide squat right here. That narrow squat gets the quads involved, top of the thighs. We're gonna hit the top of the thighs. We're gonna hit the inner thighs. We're gonna hit the abs and the booty today. Nice. You got 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna do a bear crawl, so come down to a tabletop position. Shoulders are stacked over wrists, hips over knees. Tuck the toes under and just hover the hips off the mat for 3, 2, 1. Tap the knees back down. I'm sorry, you're hovering the knees, not the hips. Hover the knees off the mat for 3, 2, 1. Tap back down. You're gonna feel your core engage in the top of the thighs. Again, lift and hold. Hold for 3, 2, and 1. Nice. From here, sit back. I'm gonna turn to face you. Sit back and give me a nice quad stretch. So plant one hand to the ground. Big reach up. Press your hips towards me. Open up through the quads, the top of the thighs. Feels really good, doesn't it? Set it back down. Other side. Used to do this stretch all the time in my bar classes. Feels so, so good. Nice work. Bring it up to a standing position. We're gonna go ahead and get started with our six bodyweight exercises. 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. I'm gonna show you your first move. It's a sumo squat with a calf raise. So it looks like this. Heels in, toes out, drop down to the bottom. Can you pop your heels off to the ground and then stand up on your tiptoes, roll back to the heels. So lower, pop, lift, drop. That's your first move. You're gonna do it for 40 seconds of work, followed by 20 seconds of rest, and we are gonna just fly from move to move to move. I'll explain each move on your rest as we go. Are you guys ready to do this? First move, heels in, toes out, shoulders stacked over wrists, squeeze your core nice and tight. You are on in 3, 2, let's go, 40 seconds. Lower, lift, drive, nice. So lower the hips, pop the heels, stand up tall, then roll back to the heels. Can you add that calf raise? Woo, it's gonna challenge your balance and challenge your core. Option, you can always take the calf raise out and just give me plie squats right here. As you stand tall, think about pulling the inner thighs together. The minute you roll to the toes, you should actively feel those inner thighs, which are your adductors, turn on, okay? We're hitting glutes and thighs right here. Core stays actively engaged. Nice work, awesome job, you guys. You're in the final 5, 4, 3, 2, and last 1. Stand tall, 20 seconds of rest. Move number 2 is a lateral lunge and a crunch. We're gonna go to our right first. So I'm gonna go lateral lunge, tap down, drive, option, tap the toe, crunch, option, lateral lunge, balance, and crunch. We're gonna stay just on the right side of the body. You're on in 3, 2, let's go. So lateral lunge, drive, crunch, woo, find that balance. Lateral lunge, drive, knee to elbow crunch. Nice, so it's a standing crunch, hitting the booty, inner thighs, and abs, what this workout is all about, abs, butt, and thighs. Now if you need more stability and balance, you can always tap, crunch, set down. lateral lunge, tap, crunch. Set down. If you want to challenge your balance, drive it up. Woo! The more you challenge your balance, the more your core is going to be forced to recruit muscles and turn on. Nice. Sit back, drive tall. You get three. Give me one more. Two and one. 20 seconds of rest. Move number three, we're going to come back to that bear crawl position. So it's that tabletop. You're going to hover off the mat. Option A, you're going to hold here for 40 seconds. Option B, you're going to give me alternating kickbacks. So you're going to tap alternating toes back, okay? Go ahead, take a nice quick wrist stretch and get yourself set up. Tabletop in three, two, one. Tuck the toes under. Knees are just gently hovering off the mat. Core is actively turned on. Option A, hold here. Soft bend in the elbows. Option B, can you alternate? Tap back, in. Tap back, in. This is a quad burner. Woo, try and keep those knees nice and close to the mat. So the top of my thighs are actively turned on. My core, low abs are working, right? Abs and quads right here, thighs and abs. Tap back, tap in 10 seconds. Yes, you can, you're doing it. Come on, stay in it. Right here, final five, four, three, two, and one. Sit it back, nice work. We're gonna go to a single leg chair squat. So pull a chair, couch, bench, whatever you have into play. Single leg squat. So I'm gonna start standing on my right leg. My left leg is kicked out, foot is flexed to engage the top of my thigh. I'm gonna sit back into a squat, setting my butt on the chair and getting right back up. Let's go, 40 seconds. Sit down, stand up. Tap the butt to the chair, stand up. Keeping this leg floating if you can, not just dropping into that chair, but slow and controlled lower, stand up tall. Hello core, hello glutes, hello top of thigh right here, right? Woo, hitting it all right here. If this is too intense for you, set this leg down, kickstand, sit back and up. Sit back and up. Still putting 80% in my right leg, 20% in this heel. Come on, you got 5 seconds. Five, four, three, two, and stand tall. Nice work. Shake it out. Awesome job. We're gonna turn that chair around now. A bar favorite move of mine. Hands gently rest on the chair. Narrow squat. Kick your butt. Kick your butt. Where your feet land. Feet are directly underneath my hips. Come up onto your tiptoes. Might need to step away from your seat. Lower down into a chair squat. Option A. Hold here. Hold here. Option B. Down an inch. Up an inch. Down an inch. Up an inch. 40 seconds. It's a tiny movement. Whew, you are going to feel the tops of your thighs engage. Hello, core is turned on. Down an inch, up an inch. Think about dropping your tailbone straight to the ground. If you wanted to intensify this and add even more thigh engagement, you could take a kid's toy ball, a Pilates sponge ball, put it between your knees and squeeze. Squeeze as you lower. Squeeze as you lower, right? Hit those inner thighs. Nice. Right here. Stay with me. Legs are shaking. Final five, four, three, two, and shake it out. Whew, that one burns. Last move, we're going down to the ground. It is a single leg glute bridge with a crunch. So I'm gonna put my right leg high to the sky. Hands are at my side to start, actually. Foot is flexed. As I lift my hips, I lift my leg, bring it down, crunch. Three, two, let's go. So lift, crunch, lift, crunch. So I'm working my left glute, my right thigh, and my abs. Lift, lower, crunch. Lift, lower, crunch. Nice work. Complex move right here. Abs, butt, and thighs. Keep those hips square. As you lift, you could always take this to a double leg glute bridge if that's more comfortable for you. Pull in. Nice work. Move six right here. Finish it strong. One more time through this set right here. You got three, two, and one. Awesome job. We're gonna go and do this again, right? You got 20 seconds of rest. Grab a quick sip of water. We're gonna repeat those six bodyweight exercises. Okay? Nice low impact workout, solid strength training. One of my favorite little routines. Heels in, toes out, sumo squat with a calf raise. Lower, lift, you're on. Let's go, your 40 seconds starts. Lower, pop to the toes, drive up. Driving up on the toes, woo, increases that thigh engagement. A lot of work for the calves right here, a lot of work for the inner thighs. A nice little sequence. You could do this pregnant, Woo! Challenge that balance. Postpartum, good low impact workout to target some of those common areas we want to hit, abs, butt, and thighs. Woo! Nice work. 40 seconds. Come on, last time you're going to do this move. You're in the final 5 seconds. Lower, lift, and drive for 3, 2. You got one more in you. Yes, you do. Nice work. Awesome job. Lateral lunge and crunch. We're going to go to our left. So it's that lateral lunge. Bring it up and crunch. Option, you can tap. Okay, if you got a pregnant belly, omit the crunch. Give me lateral lunges. You're on in 3, 2. Here we go. Lateral lunge, tap, crunch. Tap, that's option A. Lateral lunge, tap, crunch, tap. Option B, lateral lunge, balance, crunch. Right there. Lateral lunge, balance, crunch. Nice work, you guys. Choose your level. The beautiful thing is you get to come back and repeat the workout. So you can get better at it. If you're tapping, maybe make it a goal to come back and do this workout without tapping, right? Come back, try it again, no tapping. Lateral lunge, drive, nice work. Down, up, woo, find that balance. You got 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Walk it off. Nice work. Back to that bear crawl exercise. This is a challenging one, right? Okay, tabletop position, knees hover off the ground. Option A, you hold here, tap down when you need to and take a break. Option B, you're gonna give me those alternating kickbacks. This is what I call core, booty, quads. Yep, you're on in 3, 2, let's go. So slightly lift those knees, hovering off the mat. Option A, stay here. Think about gripping the floor actively, right? Keep that core turned on. Option B, give me a tap back center, tap back center. Think about keeping those hips square and stable, right? If you have something resting on your back, a glass of water, you don't want to spill it. Keep that core tight right here. Quads on fire. One of my favorite moves. This doesn't look that hard, but if you're doing it, you know it's hard. 10 seconds. Yes, you can. Whew, feel that core. Feel the top of the thighs. Whew, you got it. Final 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome job, you guys. That single leg chair squat. That's where we go. A variation of a pistol squat, if that's something you're striving for or working towards. Okay, standing on my left leg this time. Right leg is gonna go out, foot is flexed. Squeezing the quad, the top of this thigh. Sitting back onto the chair, don't miss the chair. Stand up, you're on in 3, 2, let's go. Sit it back, stand up. Now as you advance maybe in this workout, this is something you could always add weight to, right? You wanna make it harder? Add weight, add a dumbbell that pushes out. Farther you push away from your body, the harder it's gonna be. You can always advance every move. You can make it easier by putting this leg right here on the ground, kickstanding it. Really good for knee stability and strength right here, this exercise. Good for knee strength. Squats and lunges hurt your knees. That means you probably need to strengthen your knees. This is a great way to do that. You got 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Now we're gonna flip that chair around. Tiptoe chair squats, right? So again, if you had that sponge ball, you could put that in between your legs to intensify this. You're gonna come into a narrow squat stance up to your toes. If you got a pregnant belly, you can always widen your stance. Lower your seat. Whew. Find that nice chair squat right here. 40 seconds, you ready? If you're with me, you can stay here. Just using the chair for a little bit of balance and support. Think about keeping that core tucked in nice and tight right here. Dropping my seat towards the ground, down an inch, up an inch. Feeling the quads, the top of my thighs activate and fire. If I have a sponge ball between my legs, I'm keeping constant tension on that sponge ball. Down an inch, up an inch. Again, a move you might be watching and think, that doesn't look that hard. But if you're doing it, you know it's hard. Oh, it burns, it burns. Yes, you can. 10 seconds here, come on. Yes, you can. You can do anything for 10 seconds. You're so stinking strong. Stay with me. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We should do a close-up there of my legs just shaking. Woo, shake it out. Awesome job, you guys. Okay, come back down to the ground. Single leg glute bridge with a crunch. As I'm gonna be on my right leg is gonna be heel to the ground. Left leg is kicked out. As I lift the hips, I lift the leg, bring it in. Knee to elbow crunch. In 3, 2, let's go. So lift, crunch. Lift, crunch. Nice work. Glute bridge. If this is too much movement for you, you can always take it to a single leg glute bridge or a double leg glute bridge. Nice work, you guys. As I lift my hips, think about keeping my hips square as they lift up. Nice. Don't let this one fall behind, right? Nice. Don't let that left hip drop right here. Pull it in. 10 seconds here. Finish strong. Awesome job. Woo. Final. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work, you guys. We're going to roll right over to our side and take a quick stretch. This was a lot of quads, right? Pull the heel towards the glute. Take a nice quad stretch. A lot of quads. So we talk about thighs. Quads are a really active part of our thighs. We hit the inner thighs a lot too, but really targeted the quads, the top of the thighs. Whew. And it burned. You're going to feel this tomorrow, right? So this is a good stretch right here. Think about tucking your tailbone towards me. Hold for 3, 2, and 1, up and over. This is a great beginner workout, a great low impact workout. Like I said, you can scale this. You can make it harder by adding weight, right? Take it at your pace. Great postpartum, pregnancy friendly, right? Adjust as needed. You know your body best. Nice little movement using just your body weight. Nice, come up to a seated position. Awesome job. We're gonna go ahead and take a butterfly stretch. Pull the soles of your feet together. Get those inner thighs. Push the elbows into the inner thighs. Slightly hinge your hips forward. Nice work. Thank you so much for joining me for this workout. I hope you enjoyed it. And we have a lot more workouts like this. Low impact, strength training. We also have high impact, high intensity, pregnancy friendly, postpartum friendly. You can find them all at nourishmovelove.com. Hit subscribe to our channel so we can come back and see you for more workouts soon.